bad veil off of him. That's a worse burst.
So, okay. So, like, what I'm imagining here is that, like, there's, like, in the... And White Beast is Michigan, right?
Yes. Detroit area, okay. Absolutely.
I'm imagining that there's some sort of, like, Michigan FGC wiki where it's got, like, one of the entries is all of White Beast's different names.
I don't know if there's that, but, so Jay, who we saw earlier...
Yeah.
Runs recurring Void Effect, the weekly Friday thing where we do like net play exhibition matches.
Oh yeah, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Yep, RB.
Oh, that's based out of here.
Yes.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, that's Jay that does that. And so what? One week there was White Beast was one of the players up, and Jay, without telling me what he was going to be doing. Hits me up in DMs and just asked me for like all the White Beast names I got, all the Wupu's names in the book, and then so on like the title card he had for the background.
Oh, it was like the Unis text, but with
just like all these different names. It was hilarious.
All right,
so good.
So we're gonna get some buttons here, and then we're gonna get into the game. So this is interesting here because Phonon doesn't have a hurt box on most of her normals, right?
Yeah, for sure.
So her whip can go through some of the diamond or some of the gem setups that Batista has, where other characters might not be able to. Is that correct?
I believe so.
Okay, cool.
I think a lot of it is just going to be about trying to preempt Batista, trying to read the habits for how she's like trying to zone and all that.
So you would imagine this to be a very patient game today.
Yeah.
Okay.
I would hope so. I would hope so.
All right. Let's see how it goes. I'm excited for this. So jockeying for position here. Phonon is giving up a little bit of space here. I feel like I don't know if that's the right way to play this matchup. Because I feel like you'd want to be in Batista's face rather than give Batista the room to set up.
Yeah, and especially against White Beast. White Beast loves his own.
Yo, that gym setup! You popped the gym from across the screen with the laser in the air. That was so cool. Oh my god, I love video games.
Batista's sick for sure. Cheap, but sick.
Yes. Well, this is what I was saying. Like, I love this character, and it's completely in my wheelhouse. I just cannot do that stuff with her. So I feel what Corey's doing here is trying to use this first round to try to slow things down and just get a sense of the dynamics of things, which is a very that strikes me as like a mark of a well-experienced player who is playing with intention, because they're trying to use the first round to try to figure out and gauge things and see how it's going to go. So that then you can apply all that knowledge that you've got for the rest of it.
Yeah,
you don't want to just go ham off the bat and get blown up for going ham.
Yeah, unfortunately, she's just kind of been ended up in the Batista vortex. One of the few characters with an unreactable
overhead.
See
how this round start goes this way. Okay.
4B. Yep.
That's a good round start.
That's a good one.
And of course, no counter hit damage on Batista either. So that kind of takes away one of Phonon's strong suits, I believe. Nice 4.1k combo. Still has meter for another move here. I don't want to see meter spend on this combo. I would have preferred that meter because there's no CS. So now Phonon has no bailout options because doesn't have Vorpal, doesn't have 100 meter for some sort of option there. So now we could see something, but that
yeah.
There's
I think if you have like at least 150 meter, it's probably okay. You're gonna build it back pretty quickly.
Oh no, still worked out.
Yep. Still got
I got so nervous after that fireball dropped. My heart skipped a beat. I can't lie.
Yeah. Great adjustment from Corimon after only one round. Like we have an actual match here for sure.
Yes, this is both players have learned things, and now we're seeing them both do the dance, and I love it. Okay, so
definitely want.
There's a little bit of micro channel there to try to win the grid cycle. That was a good plan, Corimon. You were gonna say?
Yeah, I was gonna say I still don't like using the B Rekka there because it did give White Beast a lot of space to get back to his comfort zone.
Oh, does B Rekka leave the opponent with more space?
Yeah, B Rekka is the one that puts him up in the air. If you do the A Rekka, it's just a knockdown.
Oh, okay. Does B Rekka give you more damage or something instead, or?
I think it might, and I think Corimon might have been just thinking of getting the space in time to win the grid cycle.
Shield break and does not have 100 meters, so can't go for a veil off to try to restore things here. Corey's gonna have to play an extremely honest game for the next about 10 seconds or so.
Or she could just do this combo.
I was trying to fill a narrative there. Give me a break. I'm doing what I can.
I mean, what you said was right. She just happened to find that hit and was able to do long combo.
Yeah, keep it going. Oh, yeah. I love these gem combos. Oh, veil off. Okay.
And this is a lot of damage. 4.3. No big deal. And ooh, that actually worked.
No, get out of here. I'm not respecting any pressure. That's game one. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh.
No, she would have she could have had it there because she had the meter.
Oh, so close.
I'm like 90% sure she could have had it there. I don't know why that wasn't a – oh, Corey. Okay, you can do it, though, Corey. Don't stay psyched out. Or don't get psyched out.
You can see White Beast is feeling a little bit stressed after that one.
Yo, White Beast is doing this Batista stuff on a regular fight stick and not a hitbox?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, White Beast, you beast. And I'm only biased because Corey was up here with me earlier, so.
That's reasonable.
No offense, White Beast. Big ups to you, but I'm pulling for Corey here. Once you do commentary with me, White Beast, I'll root for you. All right.
I'll let him know. I'll let him know.
Cool. All right, so we're seeing some channels here to try and get that Vorpal Cycle 1. Corey wins it. Catches with the force function. Nice.
Anti-air.
This would probably be about a – oh, not quite able to get that last hit of it to set up the next portion of the combo.
And so just trying to get to that optimal Photon's optimal range where it's like just outside of Batista's strong tools, but not too far that she can't contest the
Zillion
tools.
It's a very like very precise mid range location where I can't get clipped by stray crystals, but I'm close enough to hit my normals, but not so far away that I have to deal with fireball BS.
Yeah, and that was actually great there.
Oh, that had to be a bad input there. Or trying to confirm it somehow?
Yeah.
That 623C was a little weird.
I want to point out, Corey did a great job there. She ducked underneath that gem, waited for it to get popped, and then punished with 3C. That was great awareness.
Yeah, Corey is extremely good about keeping her head in the game. Not quite enough to pull out that round there, and White Beast closes it out. So now Corey's on match point. The matches have been pretty competitive, though, the rounds have been competitive. So Corey absolutely can do this.
Yeah, I want to point out just how clean White Beast's execution is.
Like
you pointed out, it is not easy doing all this on a standard arcade stick.
It's kind of incredible.
Time work.
Yeah, like on a hitbox, you see some of this stuff, and you're like, okay, I get it, because like the inputs are so clean and precise on the hitbox. Not that hitbox players aren't talented, of course.
Yeah,
but like with Batista in particular, doing front-to-back charges with 100% reliability like this? Are you kidding me?
Along with everything else.
Oh, see, the 2-2-C full screen there, that's a little too telling of the desperation there. Because, like, at that far away, I don't think Phonon can confirm off of it, and that was the last of the meter. And now White Beast knows that, okay, cool, that was your only way to open me up from there.
Yeah. To be fair, I respect it because White Beast is on match point. She has to make something happen.
Well, totally true. Yeah, I 100% see it. I just think the 2-2-C was a little too telling of, like, the desperation of the scenario.
For sure.
Because you're also at this point, too, in Eunice, where the clock really matters.
Yeah.
And that's the game to White Beast. Corey is sent to the loser bracket, and White Beast advances on.